So inshallah ta'ala we will take another story today from the Quran, and all the stories of the Quran are full with lessons that we beg Allah to make us from the people who listen and apply. In the same, even we don't have to go to another page, in the same page where the story of Sulaiman alayhi salam with the ant, the namla, in the same page, there's another story with a bird. First, it was an insect, and now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling a story between Sulaiman and a bird called al-hudhud. In English, it's called hoopoe, but I'm going to keep repeating the word hudhud. So, like we said, Sulaiman alayhi salam is marching with his soldiers, birds and jinn and you name it, huge army. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتَفَقَّدَ الطَّيْرِ وَتَفَقَّدَ الطَّيْرِ فقال, مَا لِيَ لَا أَرَى الْهُدْهُدْ أَمْ كَانَ مِنَ الْغَائِبِينَ. Now I want you to imagine this whole army, and Sulaiman noticed that there is one bird missing. Army of, Allah said, army of birds and jinn. And then he noticed that there's a hoopoe, there's a hudhud missing. Where is the hudhud? Some of the scholars said he needed the hudhud in every time he travels, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this hudhud something that nobody has. And this bird can see what's under the ground just like he sees what's above the ground. He sees the water, and he can tell Sulaiman, okay, you want water for your army? There's water right here. He can see under the ground the water, just like he sees the water above the ground. So he missed him. And look at the leadership. You're going to learn a lot of leadership qualities. The leader, first of all, noticed that one of the employees is missing, even though he has 2 million. And he checks on his people. Just like our hukam, our presidents and our leaders and our kings, they're always checking up on us and making sure everything is okay. So he noticed someone is missing. But at the same time, he said, maybe he has an excuse. أَمْ كَانَ مِنَ الْغَائِبِينَ. He is an absent for, he's absent maybe for a reason. He did not act, I am the leader and someone is missing without my permission. No, no, he said, أَمْ كَانَ مِنَ الْغَائِبِينَ. He gave a room for the bird to express why is he not there. And then he said, لَأُعَذِّبَنَّهُ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا أو لأذبحنه أو ليأتيني بسلطان مبين. In front of everybody, I'm gonna torture him. And the scholars said, torture here means I'm gonna take his feathers one by one while he's alive. First option. Second option, I'm gonna slaughter him. Third option, or two options. I'm gonna take his feathers, or I'm gonna slaughter him, or unless he comes with a valid, clear excuse. Now imagine you are an employee and the leader is saying this about employee, he was absent. Would you be absent again? Wallahi, this is all leadership qualities. And you could imagine how can everything has to be perfect. Or, but again, he left room to show his humbleness, to show that there might be a valid excuse why the bird is not here and why he did not tell me he is not here. فَمَكَثَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ. After a very short period of time, the Hudhud came back. فقال. Now, subhanAllah. Now you coming back to Sulaiman. You know who Sulaiman? Sulaiman alayhi salam is a king. He is the Muhammad of his time. So you're coming back and you know who Sulaiman. You have to come back with really, really a major excuse. And the way you present your case has to be very strong. So the Hudhud came back and immediately he said, أَحَطُّ بِمَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ. Wow. I came to you with news that you do not know. He came with a very strong beginning that, you know, there's no room even for the king except to listen to him. I know something that you do not know. I found out about something that you, the king, you, the prophet of the time, do not know. And that's another dalil that the messengers do not know the ghaib. They do not know the unseen. They only know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed them. أَحَطُّ بِمَا لَمْ تُحِدْ بِهِ وَجِئْتُكَ مِنْ سَبَأْ بِنَبَأٍ يَقِينٍ. And I came back from Sheba, from Sabah, with 100% authentic news. 100%. That shows us that when you want to spread news or tell someone or forward something, you have to make sure it's authentic before you send it. Unfortunately, now, anything that looks good, that sound good, yalla, forward. And then after I send it to 5,000 people, I got a message from a good brother. He's saying, Ya Akhi, this hadith is fake. This hadith, one guy is sitting in his basement bored, he made it up and you forward it to 5,000 people. Oh, subhanAllah, I'm sorry. Sorry, it's too late, Habibi. You should have done your homework before you send anything specifically when it comes to the deen. When it comes to deen matters, this is not a joke. This is not a joke. Rasulullah ﷺ said, whomsoever says something about me I did not say, he have a VIP position in the hellfire. So this is not a joke, I'm sorry. No, sorry. You have to make sure in advance. I came, we're learning from a bird. I came to you with news, 100% authentic. Now look at this. SubhanAllah, in our countries, they will beat you. They will torture you. They will jail you. And then maybe they will listen to you. Why? And then if you turned out to be innocent, you're lucky if you get a sorry. No. Sulaiman alayhi salam with his king. Sulaiman, remember, ya akhwan, what is the dua that Sulaiman made? Rabbi, aghfirli, wahabli, mulkan, la yanbaghi. Ya Allah, forgive me and give me a mulk, give me a bounty no one on earth will ever have till the day of judgment. No one. So you know who's talking now. Look at the humbleness of the leader, that he's listening to a bird to present his excuse. What is the excuse? What did you see, Mr. Hudhud? He said, إِنِّي وَجَدْتُ امْرَأَةً تَمْلِكُهُمْ وَأُوْتِيَتْ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَلَهَا عَرْشٌ عَظِيمٌ. I was flying over Sabah and I saw a group of people where their king is a woman, their queen, they're led by a queen. تَمْلِكُهُمْ, the malik, the king over that is not a man, so something is weird, strange. It's a woman. And she has مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. In Arabic, if you just wanna literally translate it, she has everything. But here, كُلِّ شَيْءٍ in Arabic, it means that she has everything that a king have. ولها عرش عظيم. And she has a arsh, she has a throne that is عظيم. Keep in mind, who's saying this? The Hudhud, that is, his eyes are familiar to the Arsh of Sulaiman. Arsh of Sulaiman, you could imagine what kind of Arsh Sulaiman have. So if someone is used to the Arsh of Sulaiman and saw the Arsh of Balqis and said, it's Arsh Azim, she has Arsh Azim. She has a great throne. They said it was all gold and you name it. طيب, what's the problem? وجدتها وقومها يسجدون للشمس من دون الله وزين لهم الشيطان أعمالهم فصدهم عن السبيل فهم لا يهتدون. What is bothering you, Mr. Hudhud? What's killing you? He said, I found these people with their queen making sujood to the sun and not to Allah. And the shaitan beautified this to them so they are not guided. الله أكبر. يا هدهد, you are not مكلف, you are not responsible whether they are making sujood to the sun, they are making sujood to the moon, they are making sujood to a tree. This is not your problem. You're not going to be questioned on the day of judgment. You're just a bird. Why are you worried? And you came back and you're very in a rush to inform the king of what you saw. Why is that bothering you? Listen. أَلَّا يَسْجُدُوا لِلَّهِ. They're making sujood to the sun. Why they're not making sujood to Allah? Who's Allah to you, Ya Hudhud? Who's Allah to you? الذي يخرج الخبأ في السماوات والأرض ويعلم ما تخفون وما تعلنون. For the bird, what came to mind when it comes to Allah, he is the one who brings the clouds. The clouds bring down the rain. The rain brings the vegetation, and then I get my share of 2 grains of wheat. He's the one who brings the things that are hidden, bring them out. This is the biggest ni'mah that the Hudhud felt. For 2 grains of wheat and the nest, he felt that no one should worship other than Allah. Because of this small ni'mah, 2 grains of wheat fill up his stomach, and the small nest, he felt that this is a huge, great ni'mah from Allah, that I only, because of this ni'mah, I only should worship him. And that bothered him and killed him. Think about it. This bird is flying 2,000 miles, 2,000 kilometers from Sulaiman to Yemen. And it's a bird. What attracts the bird? The beautiful scenery. And how beautiful is Saba? لقد كان لسبأ في مسكنهم آية جنتان عن يمين وشمال. Allah told us how beautiful is Saba. Gorgeous, two gardens from the left, from the right. Beautiful. يا هدهد, all this beauty did not attract you. All this distraction did not attract you. All you saw that are people making sujood to the sun, and that bothered you? You noticed that there are people committing shirk and that killed you because you are a muwahhid? How many times we get bothered when we see people committing shirk around us? The bird boiled and came back. Not only we are not bothered, but there are some of us participating with the people of shirk and praising them. And the bird came back to Sulaiman reporting that there are people who are not worshiping Allah, and that is bothering me. With a small ni'mah, The Hudhud gets so annoyed, and came back and reported. How annoyed me and you we get when we see all the haram around us. Now look at the great king. Even though he said, I am coming with certain news, he said, سننظر أصدقت أم كنت من الكاذبين. I'm going to double check if you're telling the truth or you're lying. That's why every time someone tells you something about someone, make sure you double check. Do not immediately make your judgment before knowing, before hearing the other side of the story. اذهب بكتابي هذا فألقه إليهم ثم تولى عنهم فانظر ماذا يرجعون. Go, take this message from me, give it to them, and wait. Look at this. Finish your job. Don't just drop it and come back. Give them the message. Stay from far and see how they respond to my message. My brothers and sisters, a bird was the reason for the whole kingdom of Sheba to become Muslim. How many people became Muslim because of your manners? A bird made the whole kingdom, we all know the rest of the story, became Muslims, took Shahada, because he was very eager. He hated to see shirk spread. How many people took shahada because of your behavior, because of your the way you do business, because of the way you interact with your patients or with your clients? They loved it so much. Do you know what we do? Go to the parking lot of the police station. After we finished tahajjud, you know what tahajjud? This is the ultimate. After we finished tahajjud, the greatest ibadah, we went to the parking lot of the non-Muslims and we filled it with garbage. And on the way there is a gate between Medina Villas and the parking. We ripped it all apart because the law is to close at 2 a.m. And this is bothering me. Break it. I just finished tahajjud. Look how messed up our priorities. Ya akhi, like I told the brothers in the Dhuhr today, wallahi, leave all the tahajjud and leave all the qiyam. Just have good manners. We don't want your qiyam, no tahajjud. Have good manners. Move, we want to clean. Hadir. You're praying tahajjud for God's sake. What are you doing? What are we doing? Wallahi, akhwan. Sometimes we have our priorities messed up. Look at all the rewards in our deen. Look at all the highest rewards. You will find out they are all about how we treat each other. Pick any hadith. You're not a mu'min until you love to your brother what you love to yourself. You're not a mu'min if your neighbor is upset with you. The best thing that Allah loves, to put a surur, to put a smile on your brother's face. And so on and so on. Every hadith you can think of. Whomsoever defend his brother in his absence, Jahannam is haram for him. He will never see Jahannam. And so on, hundreds of hadith. Now what is the reward for this Hudhud because of his amal? Because of what he did, what is the reward? You know what's the reward? It's haram to kill a Hudhud. One Hudhud did something good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it haram to kill any of the species till the day of judgment. You want your children to be protected, you yourself become good. You do something. Allah protected all the species of Hudhud because of action of one Hudhud. One Hudhud. This Hudhud is not mukallaf. He did not have a messenger that told him, listen, go balligh anni ayah. Go spread the deen. No, he's not responsible. The animals and the insects, they only know two things. They know who's their Rabb. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. They know who's their Rabb. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught them how to seek their rizq. Every insect or animal, this they know. That's why when he was asked, who's Allah? It's Allah who bring the hidden seed from the ground. This is Allah to me. Not the one who gave me all this na'am. Subhanallah, ya akhwan. Look how much we could learn from a story of a bird. I called this story the wings of Tawheed. From a bird, a whole nation became Muslim until the day of judgment. And we all know how mashallah, our strong brothers of Yemen are. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised them because of a hudhud. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us learn from this hudhud and from the ant and from all the stories of the Quran. Jazakumullah khair, barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Innal muslimina wal muslimati wal mu'minina wal mu'minati wal qanitina wal qanitati was sadiqina was sadiqati was sabirina was sabirati wal khashi'ina wal khashi'at والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما